dinner plans for you and me and no one else. That don't include your crazy friends. Oh, I'm done with awkward situations empty.
Okay, good morning, everybody. Welcome back to another lesson of math. Get this, we only have 5 more lessons to go together this year. So we're getting close. Today's lesson is about area of a circle. Now, before we start with area of a circle, I want to review a little bit about circles. First of all, you'll remember that this is called the radius, halfway across the circle. Of course, if you want to go all the way across the circle, we call that the diameter. Okay, those are two important things that we're going to be talking about. Secondly, we want to remember from earlier this year, we already know how to figure out the outside distance. That's called circumference. Okay, circumference is all the area around the circle. And so circumference, we're going to just take, remember, the diameter all the way across times pi. And if you remember, pi is 3.14. So that's how we get the outside. But we're not going to talk about the outside today. We may have a question or two about it in our assignment, but we're going to focus more on what's on the inside of the circle. How much does it cover? Okay, that's called the area. How much of the circle does it cover? And to find the area, it's another formula, which we'll have in our math notes. You can look up, you can maybe write them in your math notes, or you can grab mine. So to find the area of a circle, we have to do just a really simple formula. The area of a circle is area equals radius, then square it. So we're gonna take the radius squared and then just times it by pi. That's it. So that, let's give you an example. If this radius is 10 centimeters and we wanna know the area of this whole circle, here's what we do. We'd say, okay, there's our formula. We're gonna take 10 and square it and then times it by pi. So we're going to take 10 squared, which is 100, and times it by pi. Now, if you remember, or you think back, we can do this within our heads. All we have to remember, since we're multiplying, we're going to go to the right, and we're going to go to the number 0. So we're going to go to the right twice. So our area of that circle is 314 centimeters squared. Area, radius squared, times pi. Okay, if we were to do the circumference of the circle, we would say this, diameter times pi. So now this is 10 centimeters, we want to get the diameter, we just add 10 plus 10, or 10 times 2, we get 20 as our diameter, and we take that times pi. That will give us the outside. But today we're going to concentrate what's on the inside, okay? Alright, another example of how we're going to find the area of a circle. Again, we go back to our old formula, radius squared times pi. Got the radius up here, so now we just got to square it. So again, we put our formula down, radius squared times pi. In this case, our radius is 4. And pi, of course, we always know is 3.14. Alright, now, 4 squared, 16. So I'm going to multiply 3.14 times 16. Radius squared times pi will give us the inside of the circle. So, multiplying them up, I get a grand total of 50. Oh, I got to count my decimal places. 50 and 24 hundredths centimeters squared. Again, just by radius squared times pi. Don't forget that formula today. All right, let's go to Mr. D's Nuggets. All right, one of the last Mr. D's Nuggets you're going to see this year. We're going to talk about two problems that are in today's assignment. The first one is 32 plus 1 and 8 tenths times 50. Okay, parentheses mean times. I remember PEMDAS very well. I hope you do as well. Parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division, adding, and subtracting. There is no parentheses. Well, I take that back. There is a parenthesis. Sorry. No exponents, though. Multiplication, division, add, and subtract. So I'm going to take care of these parentheses first. I'm going to take 1.8 and multiply it by 50. I'm going to use the hangout method. Just remember, you got to add a 0 at the end. So I'm going to take that and then add my 0. One decimal point, that's 90. Okay? Then I'm going to take and add 90 plus 32, giving us a grand total of 122. Right? That Again, how did I do that? Parentheses first, or I guess you could say multiplication. Multiplication. Then once I've got my total of 90 and 32, I just work left to right and add it up. Okay? Take care of your multiplication or parentheses first. Now, the last example of Mr. D's nuggets, one from last week. We got a proportion here. W is to 8 as 25 is to 20. Okay? We want to solve for W. So remember, cross product these things. That's the new thing we learned last week. Take 25 and multiply it by 8. All right? And that gives you a grand total of 200. Okay? Then over here, take 20 times W. Of course, that's just 20W. So then we write the equation out, 20W equals 200. Solve for W. All we have to do here, and there's a problem like this in the class today, is take 20 or divide into 200. 20 goes into 20 once. Subtract and bring down a zero, cover it up with a zero. Our in this case, our W is 10. So 10 is to 8 as 25 is to 20. All right, two of Mr. D's nuggets. Again, if you need any help today, Zoom, we can call. Just let me know. All right, have a great day.